Hello, Gundam fans. This is Brian92, and today I'll be looking at the 100 Master Grade Trailblazer from N-Era. And I got the model guide from Gundam Central. Link is in the description below. So another very detailed, very solid Master Grade from N-Era. It looks great. I love the overall design. And yeah, the plastic's good. Nice, tight joints. Undergated. No metal in this one, which is... I'm fine with that, as long as everything's stiff. But it looks great. A lot of little green and red metallic detailing stickers, just like the ruling. Yeah, even the thrusters on the shoulder. These shoulders are wild. Like a very pointy tall geese. Like in terms of that, because, you know, the thrusters are on the shoulders. Yeah, it looks really good. And it is actually shorter than the ruling. Like, more than I was expecting. Yeah, I mean, it's hard. The colors, the purple, blue, the purplish blue is very similar. That's the only way you can... Like, if this was orange instead of yellow on it, then I'd say they look even more close together, but they don't have to be. It's interesting that they were released so close together, and they're so different in terms of size, no metal. And it does come with a waterslide decal sheet. And I know that because it says Trailblazer right there. So that's good to have. And articulation-wise, you got a double ball jointed neck. It is kind of restricted by the collar. Arms go up and down at the torso, forward, rotate. These thrusters can rotate and go up. They can also hinge here. You got a couple hinges on this weird, where the heck this is supposed to be. And then the thrusters, oops. That was not supposed to happen, but the thrusters can move by themselves, or at least, like, separate from this piece, but attached to that. And the arms can move out, rotate below the shoulder, double jointed elbow, kind of nice tight ball jointed wrist on this one. Unfortunately, I didn't notice it until right before recording, there is a crack right on this cover. It covers the actual wrist and keeps it nice and tight. And it cracked. I didn't even know. I never had that happen before on I don't think any kit that does that, where the wrist cracked. But I can fix that with some glue. I just didn't notice until now. I was wondering why it was loose. I just wasn't paying attention. Got forward and backward at the stomach. Got some tiltage. Rotation at the waist. Ball jointed front skirt. Hinge side skirt. Hinge back skirt. The legs can go forward and back. And rotate, and out, a double joint knee, and the flap here can move on the back. Really, really pointy thrusters. You know what they look like? They look like one of those old lights for a Christmas tree. Anyone from the 80s might notice those. This flap can move a little bit, and this flap can move underneath. I'm getting a little bit of the eclipse with these parts, but it has good feet. Go forward and back. It can tilt. It can rotate. And no toes. No toe action. It's one solid piece. That I was surprised about. But you know what? I think it's okay. Because with all the stuff that it has, it's I think that would just make it fall a little bit more. It'd be more prone to tipping. Maybe that's why they did it. They knew that we don't want to leave the feet too loose. So yeah, it's got some good posability there. You do have some different hands. You've got the close hands here, which have the peg, and they're good for the melee weapons. And then you got this other kind, which is very Gundam Seed, or I think Wing, where you can swap the fingers, and you have a ball jointed thumb with a hinge. Actually, it's more like the newer Universal Sentry, I guess, with those, because the thumb has an extra joint. So you have two different styles. That's interesting. And this hand is good for the beam rifle. Got a couple different stickers on there on the side and on the, underneath scope. Some different colors. And it has, it goes pretty well into this hand. Because you got a hole in the handle. I don't know if you can see it right there. And so you can just, get it in there, push into the peg, and it's, it's pretty secure. Just to put it in the hand that doesn't crack if you have a problem like that. Still can't believe that happened. That's so weird. And then we have to come to the massive backpack that it has. This thing is glorious and ridiculous. Oops. I do have some more stickers. And the bottom ones are on a different kind of a hinge system. That wasn't supposed to come off. Then the top. And not a huge fan of the bottom one. Because you see how it goes in. I'm worried that, like, if you rotate it, that peg is going to break. Because you got a nice robust system here. And you got that little peg that's holding that on. It's not falling off. I'm going to have to glue you. So yeah, I mean, they work. It's just, I prefer the big hinges here than the weedly one down here. So that's annoying. But we can take these off. And we'll look at each one. So we got the nice cannon. Got a wing here that can move. I don't know why, but it does. A little bit of stickering, just a little teeny triangle. And that looks cool. And this is basically like you can be on the backpack or the, I guess they're funnels too. Or dragoons. Has more of a dragoon, like a direct freedom look. Because these can be put on the action base that comes, I'll show it in a bit. But you've also got a sword. Just comes out here. It slides into a part. You can kind of see the gray right there. It just slides into there. And it's a little tricky to get it in, but once you do, it goes into that gap up at the top and nice and secure. But yeah, it looks good. You got two holes here on the handle that can move. A little clear piece in there that sandwiches between the white. And yeah, it works great with this hand, the solid one, because it has the hole. This one doesn't have, it only has the peg in the front, but this one has a peg in the middle. Now the peg will go into either hole there on the top or the bottom, but I like to use the top one just closer to the hilt, and I think it rests up against the blade down here a little better. Yeah, it's not a huge sword, but I like it. And of course, you got four, because each one has one inside. So that is pretty cool. You can have dual wielding with the sword, and you still got the cannon. Now, I don't like the peg system here, because it's literally a peg instead of a port, like seed kits usually are. So, not really a fan of that, because if you have the backpack off, it looks really unsightly. So we'll just put that on. And then we can do over the shoulder, and we can do under the armpits. See, this is what I'm talking about. I'm worried about, don't rotate it from out here. Rotate it from at the base of the backpack, because I'm just really scared it's going to break. And I don't want that. And there are little tabs that stick out. They're supposed to gear it into a certain way. But they don't, they're already starting to kind of like fray. Because I've rotated it without doing it at the base, and I think I did that. And yeah, that's a very, very freedom-like. I do like it. And I do want to talk about the included stand, because you can use it with the weapons. So you got this little setup. It's very different from the ruling one. It's more simple. You got the joint here that can go up and down. And you actually, I like this, you have a little button inside. So you push it, and then you can rotate. Push it again and it locks. That's kind of cool. And you got a little bit up here you can push. So you can rotate that. And then lock it in place. Now where it goes is a little weird, because you can see that it doesn't really look that, like, it doesn't really stick out that much. But once you see it, you can't unsee it. And so it's always like there. But I mean, hey, it works. I can't really complain. But I am. And then you also get four rods, clear rods, because you got, you got four rods, but you got like 6 points here on the base you can pull off the covers and connect them. Alright, so I got two on here, and you might notice the connections on the top are different, because you get some of these, and you get some of these ones, because you get ones for the swords and one for the guns. So yeah, the swords are also sword bits, I guess. So if you take out the cannon, you can use this one. Peg it in there, and then I'll just take the sword out of that, might as well. So that's for the handle, so you just slide in there, actually probably the other way, yeah. So there we go, now we got a sword bit and a funnel, or a fang, I don't know. So that's really cool. I like that. I like the fact you can have both on the stand. Unfortunately, like I said, you only get four, so you can't have... It'd be cool if you got all of them out. But then again, you still wouldn't have enough places because you've only got six holes on the base, so you can only do six. I mean, you can still have them hold some of the weapons. But yeah, this thing is great. I love this thing. This model is really good. Like, all the stuff you can do with it. The backpack's really cool. Be careful of the wrist covers, because, like I said, that never had one stop before. But besides that, yeah, it is another great kit. So if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Gundam Central, and I'll see you in the next review.